So I first came out here in 2012. It was an incredibly rainy year, and I was up to my knees in water walking through this bog, and I saw evidence of charcoal on the trees. And I just thought, well, that's the strangest thing. Why is there fire in one of the wettest places in North America?
Over most of North America, fire is a common occurrence. But the west coast of North America is fairly distinctive and different from the rest of the continent. The combination of very, very wet weather, some of the highest rainfall in North America, in the world really, in combination with the lack of ignition sources, there are fewer lightning strikes in the coast of British Columbia than just about anywhere else in North America, means that fire is not a common occurrence on the coast of British Columbia. And so the general assumption has been that this is the case for most of the coastal temperate rainforest. But until recently, nobody's really looked at that closely in the central and north coast of British Columbia.
So I went exploring and I found dozens of trees that had all burnt out. And I started asking all these questions, you know, like, well, how could a fire burn here? Why did a fire burn here? Why do we not know anything about fire in this landscape or fire in coastal temperate rainforests? So when a tree is lit by a fire, the bottom of it will scar, and a healing lobe will form over top of it. And then it will always record exactly when that fire happened. So this isn't just a small scale, single incident. We have these large, repeated fires on this landscape. And some of these fires really occurred close to village sites. That kind of gave us an inkling that maybe people were starting these fires.
There are lots of examples from throughout North America of Aboriginal peoples deliberately burning landscapes to maintain meadows and grasslands that produced a number of the plants that were important to them for food and probably to build up populations of deer, which was an important item for their diet. We haven't had good evidence that that might have been a practice in the central coast of British Columbia, but now some of the work that Kira Hoffman is doing is causing us to reevaluate what we think we know about Aboriginal management using fire in the central coast.
So at first we thought it might be lightning that was causing these fires, but then there's such an important human history here and a cultural history that extends since time immemorial. And when we started looking at the lightning data, we found that lightning is very, very rare, and people were very abundant here. And so it seems that people are purposely setting these fires. So these are really low intensity fires. So they're creeping ground fires, and some of them may burn over an entire year. Some of them are small, but I think the big thing is that they were very carefully controlled, and they were carefully managed to increase the health of the forest. And they would have had those burns in order to clear the landscape around their village sites, to keep it open, so no one maybe would sneak up on you, to have plants that they wanted, plants they specifically chosen to surround their village sites that were edible or very important culturally. So fire could be a really important component of this ecosystem, and we just don't even understand the general ecology or the far-reaching implications of fire here.